offensive coordinator Pete Sturbick joins us. And Pete, from the offensive perspective versus Trinity, 400 plus yards of total offense, kind of a good evaluation there.
Yeah, it was kind of the beginning and the end was a real good for us on offense, but the middle was pretty good. Our second, third quarters, we put together some great drives. Just kind of shot ourselves in the foot early on and at the end of the game, but definitely excited anytime we can be productive like that offensively. And I thought we'd get more than 28 on the board as the game was going along, but obviously that's good enough to win, so I'm okay with it.
How about on the ground between Dante and Darrell, both of the 100 yards?
Bob, I've been wondering when that's going to happen. You know, they get some pub early on in the paper and stuff like that about being two of the best backs in the NAIA, and it was nice to see them break out a little bit. They're a good balance. They both have different running styles, and it was fun to see them get loose. Our O-line did a great job.
Talk about the play calls, the touchdown pass to Taylor Goble and the one to Darren Davis.
Well, we had some struggles the week before in our double tight, double wing set down there on the goal line, and we were on the 4 or 5 yard line, and I just wanted to see if we could throw it in there, and we haven't gotten the ball to Taylor enough, and he did a great job on the route. Greg threw a great ball. And then Darren Davis scored on, actually very similar play that he had scored his third touchdown against Drake the week before, and they had rolled down. We thought maybe they'd stay with two safeties, but they did roll down, and Darren just kept his route high, and Greg looked the safety way off to the other hash. You can really see it on the replay, and threw a great ball to Darren. He's wide open. It's pretty easy.
That was the sixth time that Darren and Charles of Greg have hooked up this year. What is it about that? Is there anything about that Greg is kind of feel comfort zone with Darren a little bit, or what?
I'm sure that's it. Darren's a different player than he's ever been. He's really, really went to work. He put on about 20 pounds since last year, and you can tell by looking at him. And I think that's just made it better in all phases of the game. And as far as being a receiver, I know it has, and I think Greg's recognized that. And so we've started to call some things with Darren in mind as well because of that. And so you mesh those two things and you're going to have good results, I think. So.
Now some national stats out of week four. Kind of looked up, Granby was ninth in total yards rushing and 13th in passing. Just about 50-50, so I'm sure pretty happy about that.
Yeah, that's better than it's been in the past. I mean, we started out with three straight 200-yard games, and we're efficient throwing the ball this last weekend, and that's a big upgrade from the last couple seasons. We've about 6 or 7% better completion percentage wise. We're right under 60%, which is where we want to be, right at 60. So I like where our balance is at. I think we're getting better. We're not to where we want to be yet. We got to protect the ball a lot better, that's for sure. But we're getting there.
Now to Olivet Nazarene, what do they present to you defensively?
They're a little bit like Black Hills State in their scheme, less aggressive with their alley players. They don't play down tight to the line. I think they kind of worry about the pass a little bit more, it seems like. They got beat pretty good by St. Francis this last weekend, but then they beat Co., a team that we had scrimmaged earlier in the year, who we think pretty highly of. They beat them in overtime, so they're definitely a team we have to prepare well for, and protecting the ball, like we always say over and over again, that's going to be huge for us.
Is it a little more difficult to evaluate a team when they played such a difficult schedule? You don't maybe not get the quite of who they really are.
Yeah, definitely. We looked at their schedule early on. We knew they kind of had a gauntlet to run through, and they did get a win, against a team that was ranked in Division III. So I think that says something for them. But it definitely is. You got to keep that in mind. They're not playing teams with losing records, and they're playing some of the top-ranked teams in the country. So we got to remind our guys of that as they watch. That's for sure.
All right, Pete. Thanks. Offensive coordinator Pete Sturbick.
I never let you down, I'ma shine on sight. Keep your mind on your grind and off of mine's alright. Right, hard, I'ma ball on those squares. I float in $250,000 cars everywhere I go. I know, in the lead it may seem he might be, but no matter what they doing, they don't do it like me. Like a G, I hold it down for the town I'm at. In a flash like that, recognize I'm back. Strike a match, catch a fire, and a moment I decide that's enough for all your life.